In 2010, Obsidian Entertainment made Fallout New Vegas, a spin-off title made to bridge the gap between Bethesda's Fallout 3 and 4. Although meant to be a throwaway title, many fans now consider New Vegas to be not only the best Fallout game, but also one of the best RPGs of all time. And I tend to agree with them. I think Fallout New Vegas is a very good game. So, when many years later, Obsidian announced The Outer Worlds, a spiritual successor to New Vegas in a setting more reminiscent of Mass Effect, people were excited, and why wouldn't they be? It looked like a perfect love letter to New Vegas fans, and with the recent release of the very unpopular Fallout 76, many were anxious for a good RPG to be made. I downloaded The Outer Worlds the first day it came out, extremely excited to see how Obsidian would beat Bethesda at their own game yet again. I played it, created my character, explored the first town, soaking up every detail I could find, left the planet, and stopped playing for the day. I thought to myself, this is a great game so far, I can't wait to see what they do next. I only played a couple more hours the next day before stopping and moving on to another game, never touching my character's world ever again. I couldn't explain what I had been feeling at the time, but I can now say that I was disappointed with The Outer Worlds. In fact, I realized that my first time playing The Outer Worlds was surprisingly similar to when I played Fallout 76 for the first time. Making a character, went through the first town, left, and stopped playing forever. In fact, I actually have more hours put into Fallout 76 than The Outer Worlds. How did this happen? Let me just say right now that I think Outer Worlds is a much better game than 76. From an objective standpoint, The Outer Worlds runs better, has way less bugs, and has mechanics that I can tell actually function as they're supposed to. It also, you know, has actual NPCs, which Fallout 76 somehow didn't have. Okay. I think this is a pretty fair comparison to make, despite the difference in scope between the games, because they both have a very similar rhythm to their gameplay. You explore the open world until you find a quest to complete, which often will involve some sort of combat, whether it's while you're moving to the quest location or at the location itself or whatever. After killing the enemies, you loot their bodies and the immediate surroundings for weapons, armor, food, money, pretty much anything that's not nailed down. Eventually, you finish the quest, get rewarded, and move on to another adventure. Obviously, each game has their own unique quirks and nuances, but at their core, that's what they are. Let's talk about Fallout 76 first, because its combat isn't the best. Because the game is always online, there's always a strange delay between hitting an enemy and the game actually registering that they got hit. Maybe my internet just sucks, but from what I've seen, this is a problem for pretty much everybody that plays this game. Besides that though, I mean, everything else is pretty solid. I mean, don't get me wrong, there's still a lot of glitches and stuff, but there's a lot of different weapons to use and modify, and the enemy variety, while not great, especially early game, has a surprising amount of different creatures to fight, both new and old. I mean, it's basically just Fallout 4's combat, but a little laggy, and personally, I really enjoyed Fallout 4's combat, so it works for me, I guess. The Outer Worlds reminds me a lot of Fallout 4 too though, so no bonus points there, and hey, this game doesn't lag at all, so that's a plus. My issue with this game's combat is that it feels kind of pointless. See, there are two reasons why you would want to fight something in both games outside of story or quest requirements. Items and experience points. In Fallout 76, both of these are essential. I always felt like I was a little under-leveled in 76, so working towards the next level was always a good idea. And as far as items, I think I use almost everything I picked up in Fallout 76, and I picked up pretty much everything. Weapons, armor, healing items, even random junk, everything can be made useful thanks to the game's crafting mechanics. Yes, these crafting systems are unnecessarily grindy and kind of not explained very well, but they are genuinely useful. Everything serves a purpose in Fallout 76. I can't say the same for The Outer Worlds, unfortunately. The random junk in this game is actually random junk, it doesn't do anything, it isn't worth selling. Food isn't really helpful since the buffs it gives you are very situational, actual healing items are everywhere, and again, they don't sell for very much. Despite all this, I never really felt like I was short on cash, and there wasn't anything that I wanted to buy anyway. That leaves weapons and armor, which, yes, were occasionally useful upgrades, but never really felt impactful enough for me to be grateful for what I found. And the variety is shockingly low. I was finding repeat items really quickly. Quick side note, by the way, the armor in this game looks ugly as hell for some reason. Like, come on, what even is this? Now some of you may be asking, what about XP? Isn't leveling up in this game really important? Not just for the combat, but for other skills like dialogue and science too? Well, I've been stepping around this for a little while now, but I think I figured out the fatal flaw for The Outer Worlds, one that stopped me from getting invested. The Outer Worlds is too easy. For the entire time I played this game, combat was never even remotely challenging. I passed every single skill check that was thrown at me, and there was no one that I couldn't persuade, threaten, or lie to. Even when I made a second character that I specifically made to be uncharismatic and dumb as a brick, I was still passing skill checks. You genuinely can't fail these. I couldn't care about leveling up in this game because they give you so many skill points to use that I was overpowered from the get-go. Even the perks felt uninteresting. I mean, to be fair, the same goes for Fallout 76 too, but at least those had a tangible impact on my character. This is nothing. But you know what? I can accept this. I can excuse the lackluster combat in this game since it's not really the main focus. The writing is. And the writing is really good. There's some fantastic world building going on with all the NPCs, which again Fallout 76 somehow doesn't have. There's a surprising amount of both silly and dark humor, which I'm always a fan of.
Is that him? Oh, that idiot. I told him to plant the beacon and move away, not stand there holding it.
This guy is basically Doc Brown from Back to the Future, which is automatically a plus in my book. All of the companions are super charming and have surprisingly deep personal quests to do. The first big choice I had to make in this game regarding the first town was a genuinely tough problem to solve. I actually had to pause for like 10 minutes just to think about what I was going to do and what was the best option. In my opinion, the writing of The Outer Worlds is great enough that it outweighs the lesser parts of this game. Is what I would say if there wasn't so much damn fighting. I swear, more than half of my playtime of this game was spent on pointless, boring, repetitive combat while I was trying to get to the actually interesting parts. And don't even get me started on the actual maps themselves. There's nothing f***ing there! You won't find any people outside of towns, and there's no interesting landmarks to make you want to explore. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Fallout 76 did this better. There are actually some pretty cool places to discover, and the fact that you can see where some things are immediately on the map definitely helps. You better believe that as soon as I saw a giant teapot on the map, I immediately booked it over there. And there it is. Okay, I thought it would be a little bit bigger, but whatever. But giant teapots aside, I can't say that Fallout 76 is better than The Outer Worlds, can I? I mean, sure, The Outer Worlds combat isn't great, but Fallout 76 barely functions, and in terms of writing, The Outer Worlds knocks Fallout 76 out of the park. I mean, Fallout 76 doesn't even have NPCs, there are no actual characters, right? While I was writing the script for this video, Fallout 76 released what they called the Wastelanders update, which added, among other things, a brand new storyline and, get this, actual characters that you can talk to and interact with. Oh my god, are those skill checks? That I can actually fail? And correct me if I'm wrong, but this guy is surprisingly charming.
But ever since I turned, there's always this nagging feeling just at the back of my mind. I will have to feast on humans! Roar! Seriously? Nothing? Shit, I thought it was funny.
You know, I've been trying to come to terms with myself about something that I was too afraid to say for a long time, but after making this video and seeing the Wastelanders update, I think I'm finally ready to say it. I'm ugly and I'm proud. What? No, that's not... What I'm trying to say is... I like Fallout 76 more than The Outer Worlds, and I can't believe I'm not sponsored to say that.